Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Daisy. For today's video, we're going to be talking about the famous call from the radio show La Mano Peluda. So if you guys are interested, grab your snacks, grab your cobija, and let's get straight into it. So today's case is going to be quite different. We are going to be talking about the famous radio show La Mano Peluda. For my non-Spanish speakers, the hairy hand. People would call in to share their paranormal experiences with the host, Juan Ramón Sáenz.
Soy Juan Ramón Sáenz. Esto es La Mano Peluda.
One particular call, however, would impact not only the listeners, but the very host, Juan Ramón. In 2002, a caller named Josué Velázquez called in the show to seek help for a certain dilemma that he had. Josué starts to explain that his family fell into a huge economic crisis, so at age 14, he began to seek different ways to earn money. He became so desperate to the point he found a book in Hebrew of witchcraft, and that book explained on how to contact Satan. So after practicing everything that he learned about a year and a half, that's when he started to get his first results. During a ritual, he summoned a demon. Now he imagined that this demon would appear to him with horns, with a tail, but it was the complete opposite. It looked like a human being. It was a tall, thin man. So that's even creepier because one would expect the way we have been told that demons look like, but no, it wasn't. It was a human being. So the demon sat next to him and Josué was in shock. He had the courage to even say, "Who are you?" And the demon replied to him, "Didn't you want to see me?" in such a calm voice. Oh hell no. So that encounter was his first experience with a demon, but it was not his last. But it wasn't until his second encounter with a demon that would completely change his life. He found another book, and that book showed how to conjure up another demon. So he just did the rituals. Once Josué finished his rituals at 2 a.m., he saw a demon as a form of a pig attacking his unconscious mother. And the pig told Josué to go with him. And Josué did. Like, what? Like, I feel crazy just talking about it. Like, what? Josué recounts that the pig took him not by walking or running, but by flying. Yes, you guys heard that right. By flying to a nearby cave where he stayed there for 21 days. And for these 21 days, they prepared him to... Well, you guys will see. They prepared him and they gave him a ring. A ring of King Solomon. Now, this ring was going to give him the ability to call upon a demon for his desires. But there is a catch. In exchange for this ring, he had to sacrifice one of his family members. So after a lot of thinking, this is ridiculous. So after a lot of thinking, Josué decides to sacrifice his own grandmother, his abuelita. Like, what? Like, I feel like... Where's the hope in society, to be honest? Like, what?
A mi abuela, recuerdo que la dormí con formol. Y repitiendo las oraciones y todo eso, bueno, hice lo que tuve que hacer. Extrañamente, cuando mi abuela se encontró muerta, ella vivía sola. Estuvo sin ninguna marca. A mí me sorprendió muchísimo porque yo le hice un montón de cosas. El anillo tenía que ir cubierto, incrustado en el dedo del corazón de ella, o sea, en el dedo medio. Sí. En el dedo medio de la mano izquierda de esta persona, y ella se encontró intacta, ¿no? Fíjese usted, señor, que después de esto ellos dijeron que ahí terminaba lo que ellos tenían que hacer, que mis plegarias habían sido escuchadas.
After he did the sacrifice, Josué says that his mind just began to open up. Because once it came time for college, with the help of his brujería, his witchcraft, and his ring, He landed an interview with the director of the National Polytechnic Institute of Mexico. And the director just simply granted him his admission. Just like that, no ifs, ands, or buts. It was like a simple yes. So Josue finishes his studies in 6 months, which would normally take the average person 8 years. But he finished it in 6 months, you guys. So Josue claims, again, emphasis on the claim, okay? Because we don't know if this is factual or not. But Josue claims that he built a successful company in Monte California and he was earning $15,000 a day. 8 days. Like, must be nice. But actually, never mind. Like, I would not pass. Pass on that. Like, mejor no, you know? I'll be broke. I'd rather be broke than making deals with the devil. But that money came with a catch. The catch was that Josue had to spend all his money in 1 day. So if he got $15,000 in 1 day, he had to spend it. So he would go to the malls and just spend it recklessly because he had no other choice. Because he couldn't do it in a good deed, nor burn it, nor just throw it away. He had to waste it. He had to spend it, but not in a generous way. And if he does so, he would have to face the consequences. For example, Josue shared an experience where a construction worker was expressing his struggles. He was telling him his struggles that he was facing, and he just had the urge to give him money, help him out. Well, when he got home, things did not go well for him. When he returned back home, a woman was waiting for him. That woman attacked him and she was so upset that he gifted the money. He described this woman to have a fair complexion, long black hair, very thin, and had no legs. During that phone call, it seems so eerie because Josue seems very frightened. Like, the woman is torturing him during the phone call.
Lo que me espanta es lo que trae en la mano.
¿Qué trae en la mano?
No, espérate. Oh, por Dios, I'm so much skillful. Ya me tranquilicé. Tengo en mi poder este anillo que me dieron, con lo que puedo dominar muchas cosas. Trae en la mano un... Es un símbolo, no sé cómo se llama, pero les explicaré cómo es. Es una punta, como si fuese de flecha, que trae como si fuese una cruz cristiana invertida. Y en el puño trae un ojo de cristal o algo así. Y yo sé que eso es muy malo porque a mí me dijeron que cuando yo viera eso, me iba a morir.
So Josue was seeming to be at the point of regret during the phone call. He told Juan Ramon Sainz that he even tried to take off his ring that they gave him. And that fit, according to him, fits him really loose. But while trying to take off his ring, he dislocated his finger. So Juan Ramon Sainz, the host, I like to remind you guys who's who because sometimes I even forget, like, wait, Josue, you know, but I got you guys. So Juan Ramon Sainz, the host, he decided to contact a pastor that he knows to help Josue out. So the next day, Josue did call back into the show and spoke with the pastor, Roberto Guaso. Now, that call was intense. Intense. More than the initial call. During the call with the pastor, it became really creepy just listening to what was going on Josue's line.
Esto... ¿Qué características tiene que tener Josué? ¿Qué está pasando, Josué?
No, están hablando, están gritando estos seres, pero no pasa nada, señor, continúe.
No prestes atención a esas voces, en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. Josué, en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. Cristo Jesús es mayor. Cristo Jesús te ama. Cristo Jesús te quiere limpiar y liberar. Cristo Jesús es mayor y quiere hacerlo. En el nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. En Cristo Jesús. No prestes atención.
No, es que Dios mío, no, yo no escucho nada, yo no escucho nada.
No escuchas nada.
No escucho nada.
En el nombre del Padre, del Hijo, del Espíritu Santo, en este momento declárate, yo pertenezco a Cristo. Declárate, yo pertenezco a Cristo.
¿Qué me están hablando, güey?
Yo pertenezco a Cristo.
Yo pertenezco a Cristo.
Those prayers were definitely provoking the beings that were there surrounding Josué. Just the laughs that were coming through the radio show, oh no, 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 the chills. And I just can't imagine listening to this live when all of this is going down. Like, I would have been like, change the station, change it, change it. But there wasn't only things happening in Josué's house. There was also things happening in the studio where Juan Ramón was at. He says that there was cool air coming from under the table, like cool wind. And also he said that the Bible pages were rolling up.
Empezaron a pasar cosas en la cabina. Alguna vez les platiqué que mi laptop sacó un destello, que empezó a salir aire frío, o más bien frío, debajo de la mesa, que la Biblia se me hacían rollitos las hojas de la Biblia cuando quise hacer oración, mientras él estaba hablando con un pastor, con el pastor Huaso.
So Josué and the pastor continued to pray, but we clearly hear that it was very difficult for Josué to continue to pray, since there was four entities around him, just tormenting him, taunting him. But unfortunately for Josué, the show had to end, so Juan Ramón had to disconnect the call.
Cuídese mucho, Josué. Llénese de energía y de fuerza espiritual, ¿ok?
Muchísimas, muchísimas gracias.
Que Dios lo bendiga.
Hasta luego, que Dios te bendiga.
Hasta siempre.
Gracias, Josué. El lunes vamos a platicar y verá que todo está mejor, ¿ok?
So let's fast forward to 9 years later. The host from La Mano Peluda landed a job in a television show called Extra Normal. So the show wanted to do a segment on Josué since it was a very popular show in La Mano Peluda, and also people were just curious to what happened to him. So they contacted Josué and Josué agreed to do the interview. So on May 19, 2011, they did the interview on a boat surrounding water. And apparently the reason why they did the interview in a boat surrounding water was because Josué said that it was a way for as a protection that the demons would not be able to attack the crew. During the interview, we can clearly see the host from La Mano Peluda, Juan Ramón Sáenz, look like he's feeling sick. He's just touching his stomach like he's in pain. It's very subtle, but looking back at it, analyzing the footage, you can clearly see that he's in some type of discomfort, pain during the interview.
Aquí tenemos agarrado una deidad que estaba como un perro rabioso queriendo hacer cosas. Entonces se ata para que no pueda ya hacer más daño, sobre todo para poder tener esta entrevista sin ningún problema. Y es que cuando me reúno con Juan Ramón, fusionamos cosas y llamamos cosas. Hemos visto, Juan Ramón, que
some strange things did happen during the interview. For example, Josué, he would have these terrible trembles.
Las ganas de ay.
Ay, se me subió.
As if like someone was going to possess him. But overall, it was normal. It finished normal, nothing too crazy. Everything seemed like it was fine. But unfortunately, that was not the case, because something huge coincidence happens that Juan Ramón is pronounced dead a week later after the interview. On March 29, 2011, he was pronounced dead.
El parte médico declara que aquel domingo de 2011, Juan Ramón Sáenz dejó este mundo a causa de un agudo cuadro de peritonitis.
And if you think, okay, that can be a coincidence, no, no, no. A week after his death, the pastor died. Okay, now something's not adding up here. Now, a week after that interview, one of the camera crew guys went to the hospital. He was hospitalized, it was an emergency, and it had to do with a hernia that he had.
También nos enteramos que uno de los camarógrafos que estaba, nuestro compañero Luis Ernesto, que estaba grabando la nota, también cayó al hospital.
Es que días después yo tuve que entrar a quirófano por un problema abajo de mi vientre, una hernia que me dio problemas.
Now, if you don't think that's a coincidence, the person that interviewed Josue, the guy that's next to Juan Ramón Sáenz, got in a terrible car accident.
Fui a descansar y cuando yo iba ya hacia mi casa, iba manejando normal, tranquilo, las calles prácticamente vacías, porque pues después de la medianoche no hay mucho tráfico como en cualquier ciudad. Y de pronto sale un carro detrás de mí, pero se me cierra muy bruscamente, pero no vi ningún carro que estuviera cercano. De pronto salió y me descontroló porque se me cerró muy fuerte y fui a chocar contra un poste.
All these events made people speculate that maybe Josue had something to do with it. People even theorized that Josue exchanged the life of the pastor and Juan Ramón Sáenz in exchange to save his own life. Let me know your guys' theory. Do you even believe in Josue? Do you even think he's being truthful? Let me know down below. I would love to know, what do you guys think on this situation? Honestly, I don't even know what to think. It seems so far-fetched what Josue is saying. But you just never know. Maybe it is possible, especially since the major coincidences, the horrible events that happened after it is just insane. So I don't know, honestly guys, I don't know. Well, that was it for today's video. If there's any other paranormal topic you guys want me to cover, let me know down below. But other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.
Al mundo de lo increíble, de lo insólito, de lo sobrenatural. Soy Juan Ramón Sáenz y aquí se respira el miedo.